Hello, my name is Scott Higgins from Audinate, and in this video, we're going to discuss an introduction to video concepts. Video resolution typically refers to the spatial resolution measured in width and height in pixels, or picture elements. Aspect ratio refers to the ratio of the width to the height. Standard definition television is the original TV format. The two main ones are NTSC, used in the US and Japan, for example, and PAL, used in most of Europe and Australia. There is a third major system called CCAM that is similar to PAL and is used in France. Standard definition uses a 4:3 aspect ratio, with 4 units of width to every 3 units of height. Next came high definition, or HD. When HD was originally defined, there were 18 formats. Typically, two of these formats are the most common. They are 720 and 1080, where those numbers refer to the number of scan lines of resolution. The aspect ratio of HD is normally 16:9. After HD, ultra-high definition has emerged. UHD has typically meant 4K, or 3840 scan lines. And recently, 8K has emerged with 7680 scan lines. Next up, we'll discuss color. Normally, color is represented by 3 color channels, red, green, and blue, or more commonly referred to as RGB. The color depth is the number of bits used to store color information for each color channel for every pixel. Color depth can range from 8 bits per pixel, called true color, to 10, 12, and even 16 bits per color. Not surprisingly, the more bits of color depth, the larger the file size becomes. Another common method is called YCRCB, where the Y represents the lumens, or black and white information, CR represents the red color information, and CB the blue color information. The green channel information can be derived from the other channels. As you'll see later, there's an advantage using this method. The human eye, or visual system, is more sensitive to changes in luminance than to color. One method of compressing the video is to use chroma, or color sampling. Chroma sampling represents the relative rate of sampling the luminance and the two color channels. If we sample the luminance and color equally, this rate is referred to as 444. Taking advantage of the human visual system, we can sample the color information at less than the luminance and reduce the file size, but not impact the visual quality as much. If, for instance, we sample only every other pixel in both the vertical and horizontal direction for the two color channels, the resulting sample is referred to as 420. Frame rate is the number of consecutive images displayed per time unit, usually in seconds, and is expressed as frames per second, or FPS. NTSC is 30 frames per second, PAL is 25 frames per second, and feature film is typically 24 frames per second. Since early television technology could not handle displaying each frame consecutively, early systems displayed every other scan line, starting with the odd scan lines first, and then came back and displayed the even scan lines. This method is called interlacing, with each image, odd or even, called a field. The rates of 30 or 25 came from the frequency of the AC, or mains. In countries that use 60 Hz, the refresh rate was 60 fields per second. With the move to color, NTSC was ever so slightly slowed down to a frame rate of 29.97 frames per second. Displaying each scan line consecutively is called progressive, for instance, 1080p. As screen size have increased, the desire to increase the frame rate even higher is to minimize the visual artifacts. Not surprisingly, as video resolution, color bit depth, chroma sampling, and frame rate increase, so does the file size. For example, 8K resolution with 60 frames per second, 12-bit color depth, and 444 sampling require almost 100 gigabits per second for uncompressed images. As you can see in the chart, the uncompressed bit rate decreases as the quality factors are reduced. For instance, 4K 60 at 60 frames per second, 10-bit color at 444 requires about 20 gigabits per second, while standard definition, NTSC and PAL require about 400 megabits per second. High bandwidth digital content protection, or HDCP, is a form of digital copy protection designed to prevent the copying of audio and video signals over HDMI or other connections. HDCP is administered by the DCP, the Digital Content Protection, a subsidiary of Intel. The current version is 2.3, which is a minor update upon the previous version of 2.2. High dynamic range, or HDR, is a video technology designed to increase the dynamic range of the luminance and the chrominance, resulting in more vivid images. The original standard is known as HDR10. There are other standards such as HDR10+, supported by Amazon and Samsung, and Dolby Vision, which is a proprietary format from Dolby Labs. For encoded video, the encoded technology must pass the HDR information. Compression technology makes use of various variables such as frame rate, resolution, color depth, and chroma sampling. Compression is subject to complexity trade-offs, seeking to optimize some qualities at the expense of others. For instance, one may optimize the quality and latency, which may cause the bandwidth required to increase. The word codec is a blend of the words coder and decoder, as both parts are required. At a high level, there are two types of compression, interframe and intraframe. Interframe are motion-based codecs involve encoding a full picture every, say, 15 frames, and for the frames in between, the full encoded frames. Only the changes to the frame are encoded. This type of compression is the most popular. It is typically used for streaming as it's optimized for bit rates below 100 megabits. For instance, Netflix typically requires about 5 megabits minimum for HD video. Motion-based codecs are asymmetric in terms of requiring more resources to encode than to decode. Intraframe or picture-based codecs encode each frame individually. As such, they support lower latency use cases than motion-based codecs. Typically, bit rates for picture-based codecs are higher than 100 megabits, enabling higher quality. In video compression, the coded video and audio files inside of a video file container is called an essence. Essence-based video is used to transmit the separate files of video, audio, and metadata information about the file to potentially different destinations, all kept in sync using PTP, or the Precision Time Protocol. Bundled or multiplex video transmits the entire package altogether. Dante AV enables complex video and audio deployments. Dante AV's use of essences enables distributing video and audio separately to various output devices as needed. The example also shows how Dante AV can distribute 4K UHD video without costly matrix switchers using a 1 gigabit switch. Thank you for your time. If you have any further questions, please feel free to contact Audinate.